What is the best mousetrap design? The best mousetrap design is actually a bucket. I guess it's no surprise then that the most effective mousetrap ever made uses a bucket. The name of the trap? The Kiosk Bucket of Death. It is named after a tiny hamlet where it was essentially invented, Kiosk, Ontario, Canada. It is believed to have been created by hunters to ensure mice didn't get into their stores of food. You have no doubt heard the expression, the early bird gets the worm, the second mouse gets the cheese. That might be so with regular mouse traps but not with the Kiosk Bucket of Death, sometimes called the Wheel of Death depending on the design. Both the first and second mice die right up to the umpteenth mouse. Escape is impossible. Basically, you take a bucket, put water in the bottom, put a ramp, perhaps a 2x4, leading up to the top. Now there are two ways you can wipe out mice. The first is take a piece of rounded wood or perhaps an empty pop can with holes at each end and put it on a wire that you run from one side of the bucket to the other, and then secure the wire to the sides of the bucket. You now have a rolling pin style device. You put peanut butter on the wood or pop can and put it where you figure the mice are. Mice will ascend the 2x4, run around the edge of the bucket to the wire and walk out the wire to the wooden roller or pop can. Being hungry mice driven by the presence of food, the mice will jump onto the pop can or wooden roller to get the peanut butter. Pop can or roller spins, mouse falls and lands in water. Smooth sides on the bucket will not allow for traction. Mouse drowns. This is the version called the Wheel of Death because it spins. The original Kiosk Bucket of Death was a bit different but just as sneaky. Instead of a wire from side to side with a wooden roller or pop can on it, you affixed somewhat strong paper or flimsy wood, like balsa wood, leading out to near the center of the bucket. You then put peanut butter at the far end, near bucket center, of the paper or thin wood and put the trap where you figure the mice are. Mouse walks up wooden 2x4 ramp, gets to paper or thin wood, sees and smells the peanut butter and ventures out to get it. Since the paper or thin wood only goes out so far and is unsecured, then it begins to sag with the weight of the mouse walking on it. Perhaps before or just as the mouse gets near the peanut butter, the paper or thin wood moves downward at least 45 degrees and the mouse then falls down into the water and drowns because the smooth sides of the bucket will not allow it to climb out. Sorry PETA, this is not something you'd endorse and it is not politically correct in today's society, but if you've ever had mouse problems, this is the best design to rid you of the problem. I've had a lot of mouse damage at my cottages over the years, but this is a sure mouse stopper. I had mice this fall, 3 total, it turned out, and it took me about 3 months to get rid of them all. One went the natural way, falling victim to my dog, who is an excellent hunter. One went into a spin trap and never came out. They had been ignoring, or running over the top of, the spin traps, so I put them in a cardboard box with bait inside and a small hole in the box. Mouse number 3 proved to be quite elusive. The spin traps were ignored. I switched to snap traps, and he stole the bait. Then I superglued bait to the traps, and he ignored them. I eliminated all food sources, yet he pooped on my stovetop every night. Finally, I came up with my invention, inspired by American Ninja Warrior. That's a shoebox with a mouse-sized hole at one end. Opposite the hole, I filled an aluminum mesh tea strainer with dog food and peanut butter. Surely a cup of bait would be an irresistible scent bomb. Then I placed 6 snap traps at all angles between the hole and the scent bomb, each baited with peanut butter. I imagined ninja-like mouse acrobatics from the elusive rodent. Instead, I was greeted the next morning with a tail hanging out of the hole. He never made it all the way in.